As I've mentioned, I'm really delighted to share with you the release soon of Quantum Body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, more vital life. My book with Jack Tuzinski, quantum physicist and quantum biologist, and Brian Fertig, a fellow endocrinologist. So today I want to explore with you, and we've been exploring this in many ways, is the relationship between what we call the quantum body and the quantum mind. One way to think about this relationship is that the quantum body is the physical substrate of the quantum mind. The brain is made up of atoms and molecules, which are governed by the laws of quantum mechanics. It is possible that quantum effects at the atomic and molecular level could have a significant impact on the brain's function. For example, some scientists have proposed that quantum entanglement could play a role in consciousness. Entanglement is a phenomenon where two or more particles are linked together in such a way that they share the same fate even when they are separated by a large distance. If entanglement is occurring in the brain, it could allow for communication, instant communication, between different parts of the brain that would not be otherwise possible. One other way to think about the relationship is that the quantum mind is the observer of the quantum body. Now, I have a lot to say about that because I think quantum mind and quantum body are both observed. But let's go along with what the physicists are saying right now, quantum biologists. And what they're saying is when we observe the world around us, we are effectively interacting with it at a quantum level. This interaction could influence the behavior of the quantum body. For example, some scientists have proposed that the measurement problem in quantum mechanics could be related to consciousness. The measurement problem is a paradox that arises from the fact that quantum systems can be in a superposition of states, but when we measure them, they collapse into a single state. It is possible that consciousness plays a role in this collapse by selecting one of many possible states. As you can see, I'm reading from my notes because these are mainstream discussions happening at the moment. So here are some examples of how the quantum body and quantum mind may interact. And then lots of examples here. On quantum entanglement, quantum effects playing a role in the body's ability to process information, make decisions, etc., etc. So let's be done with my notes to say that this argument is still physicalistic. Ultimately, what is it that knows even the concept of quantum mind or quantum body or quantum world? What is that? What is the subject of all experience? It's not the mind, it's not the intellect, it's not the ego, it's not your body, it's not energy, and it's not the universe. It is consciousness. So beyond the quantum mind, quantum body is that which is the source of quantum mind, body, and the world as a unified experience. And that is not quantum. It's the source of all that we call quantum. And that source is the real you, the fundamental you, which is curving back within itself and creating the experience of mind, intellect, ego, body, and the universe. And that is pure consciousness that knows itself as both the subject and object of experience. But when I say subject of experience, I mean the so-called subject as the body mind and the so-called object as the world. But actually, both body mind and world are simultaneously modes of knowing and things known, objects known. So the mind is a human mode of knowing and experience as it appears on the screen of consciousness objectively, and the body and the world are also modes of knowing. The world that we know through the human body is very species specific and only known to the human mind. So you're neither the quantum body, nor the quantum mind, nor the quantum universe. You're the immeasurable potential of that which appears as the unlimited mind, the unlimited imagination, the unlimited range of perceptual activity that we call the body and the universe. Let me know what you think of this idea. And I'm going to start a book club on quantum body, and I hope you'll be able to join it, and we'll curate your input as well and learn from each other. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.